Are the laws in place at the moment, like you mentioned, the scrummage laws, are they as effective as they could be?
I think it's like anything, you know, we talked about the first change in the scrummage law, they found that it was probably less effective than they want to be a change. And the thing is that, you know, within any sport, but in rugby, a new law comes in, and what happens is the coaches look a way of getting around it, you know, bending the rules a little bit, seeing how they can tinker it to their advantage. And I think it's not until it gets into play and they can see how these rules can be legally changed, and you end up trying to do something positive and it ends up being negative. So I think, you know, there's a constant change of the International Rugby Board and monitoring injuries, and they've got good funding there to look at research into reducing the injury profile, and a lot of the senior countries now do an injury and illness audit, and they're constantly monitoring. And you've got stuff like Box Smart in South Africa, which is a preparatory set of exercises to reduce injury, which is quite good. That's been taken on board.
Is there anything you could suggest that could be done in the future? Anything that's on your mind that might help, would help, or could help?
I think we've got to look at, and it's all like with our sport, with the commercialism, you know, and you've heard Billy Vinopola saying there's playing too much rugby, and that's the balance you've got. To be well paid, you need sponsors. Sponsors want exposure. Exposure means playing lots of games. I think from a general player's point of view, I think that's something to be looked at. For England, and it's probably impossible now, but I think centrally contracting the players would be fantastic, because then you can manage the players' workload. You know, look at what the All Blacks do. Make a player change clubs because they want him to play in a different position, but they completely manage that player's care. So if the RFU can't centrally contract and the ship sailed a long time ago, I think it's looking to reduce the number of games that players play.
And finally, do you believe that there's a crisis of injuries in rugby union, and yes or no, and why?
No, I don't think so. I'm just trying to think, you know, I still have a lot of colleagues who work in rugby, and I do bits and pieces with clubs. I think at the senior team level, I think it's managed. My worry is, because of a lot of the stuff that I've done, is at the academy level. I think that's the bit that we need to focus on now, because that transition from adolescent to adult, some of the training that goes on around there, the levels of loading of the athletes, the type of exercise they're doing, is leading them to get some injury. Just all about being strong and getting some bulk on that. I think that's an area that we need to look at.